thin white, thin yellow. You think, oh, it's green. But what kind of green is it? It's a warm yellow green. If it was a blue green, what would you lay down? Light blue. Okay? You guys see that? You can see that, okay. The mirror in. Notice that the paper has a texture?
Yes.
Yeah, be aware of that. Okay. Okay. This is the yellow base color. Everybody look up here. In theory, you can get to this stage with three colors. About this technique is when you see the white outline, it looks like you meant to do that. You have a big heavy white out, a black outline on white, it looks kind of like a second grader did it. So this is like, oh wow.
You can make a mistake, you can just color over it with black.
You can always color over with black. Right. If you don't like it. Everybody doing exactly the same thing, and everybody looks radically different. Which is good. out. That'll get rid of the texture in the paper. Okay. And all of a sudden, there's a lot more colors have shown. You don't have to have that many. Did you notice where the colors have shown up for the shading kind of thing? There's purples and browns and grays. This exercise is often showing about layering color upon top of color upon color rather than going for it all in one fell swoop. Makes it richer. You notice the one on the screen looks three-dimensional already? Some people look like stained glass, some look translucent, transparent. One thing I've never seen is black watercolor. Have you ever seen, Amanda, have you ever seen black watercolor paper? Me either. Or colored watercolor. If anybody ever comes across colored watercolor paper, let me know. Did anybody think to put the highlight in the eye? It's already black, you can do that, because you haven't. Should this be blank? I don't know if you know, it's also when you do watercolor, if you build it up in layers and you blend it, it has this sheen to it, and when you turn it, it's almost three-dimensional, the drawing. Kind of the look you're going for. Finish the drawing, you make some sort of observation about it, you write time, date, place, you know, you could even, had a means to make the photo really small, tech, you know, whatever you want to do, but there is your, basically your finished journal page. Let me show you something. Once you've got this technique down, and you can, and once you do it, it's all the same, okay? Over and over again. For example, here's this poster, okay? It's all done with photos. And here's a poster I found. We didn't do this, but I really find it. Here's a poster where someone took photos. And look, I mean, this is a very powerful depiction, and all it is a series of images done exactly the same way that you did them. Okay? And you don't have to do 300 different ones. You could do, if you wanted to do your Emiquon, it could be 4, 6, you know, but just something that the people are going to go, oh, you know, the frogs of Emiquon, the birds of Emiquon, the biodiversity of Emiquon, you know, those sorts of things are the three different levels of Emiquon, you know, or four different ways, you know, all these sorts of things should now mature in your brain and go, oh, okay, that's what we're going to do. All right. Everybody happy with that?